Hey there, Tano. I'm Shadow Scythe, and I am officially jumping on the hype train because Banshee Prime Access is finally here. Now, let's get right down to the nitty-gritty. Now, I already did a video for her pre-release, basically, to do the comparison where no changes to shield, power is increased by 25, and armor is also increased. Well, actually, armor is increased by 50, which will help out her survivability already. But now here is the kicker with Banshee Prime. Right out of the. Now, she, of course, standard V polarity for the aura, which I will be replacing, but she comes with two V polarities and a dash polarity. Anyway, now let's see what kind of changes were made to her appear to her abilities as far as the visual changes for primes. Let's leave it on public, and what better place do I know to level than good old software? Though I will probably be regretting this here soon. Oh, never mind. Now that I think about it, I probably should have equipped Helios Prime as well to start leveling that, but fuck me.
The enemy is at our doorstep. You must defend our equipment until reinforcements arrive.
The Grineer used to be builders, but now all they do is make war.
Though I gotta admit, I love her helmet because she kinda looks a little bit like a bat. Anyway, it's still pretty much the smoky dust force push thing that she does. Ow. No real changes to her sonar ability either. Fancy little frills are actually what will glow with her energy with melee channeling, for those of you who love to do that. Wow, I missed. Like a fucking champ. Well, clearly they're better at killing stuff than I am.
Thank you.
other than there being different visual effects on Banshee herself, her the ability that's actually been cast. Yeah, if you pretty much leave her energy color the same, at least I'm assuming that it's tied to her energy color, then the visual effects per ability cast will vary. But the increased survivability is definitely nice, because I would have died 1,000 times over already if I was a regular Banshee.
Reinforcements available. Do you choose to leave now or continue fighting?
Well, looks like we're just gonna bail.
We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to
There ain't no freaking way I'm gonna attempt to do crap, can't talk. Another five waves with two of us. Alright, well, the only thing I didn't really get to show you was Sonic Boom. So, let me just quickly, because I'm not even going to actually stay for this. I'm just going to go in, drop into Sonic Boom, Soundquake, and see what it does.
There is a large platoon of Grenier Marines stationed here. Leave no one standing.
Same crackling effect. And once again, different energy effect. Alright, so for the most part, it just seems like you get different energy effects per ability cast. Because it was like a turquoise cloud for Sonic Boom. It was like orange pulsing critical points for Sonar. Silence, you pretty much had this glowing green aura on you. And then Soundquake was blue. Alright, well, now that we've got pretty much the basics for Banshee aside, let's focus on the much anticipated Euphona Prime. Now, Euphona Prime's another weapon that has no iteration before its prime. Stats without mods. And one of the biggest controversies that people were having about this, with the fact that we were seeing the stats for it, but we weren't seeing finalized stats, because people were getting all bent out of shape that it didn't have a status chance. Well, neither does the Sonicore, and people still go nuts with the Sonicore. And the Sonicore is another impact-based weapon.
Ortis has been counting stars, operator.
Now, this, however, has a status chance of 2%, and a base critical chance of 30%. Which, as you can see right here, that is a royal kicker for anybody that formas the shit out of their weapons. You saved yourself a lot of work right here because it comes with three V polarities right out of the gate. So as you can see, and I don't have a maxed Hornet Strike. I honestly, half the time I don't even use my secondary, so I don't really care. But Barrel Diffusion and Lethal Torrent more than make up for it. Then Pistol Gambit and Hydraulic Crosshairs and Quick Draw, although actually I should have a... Oh, never mind, that's Stunning Speed, which is Reload and Status Chance, and I'm not wasting... Not really going to waste the time with Status Chance. Anyway, before I actually forget, Helios Prime, Deconstructor Prime, right into the next mission. Back to Lua. And Stoffler. And as you know, Helios had a pretty much a 50 point increase to his health, and his armor was doubled, and that was pretty much the only changes to him other than the golden ornamentation.
The enemy is at our doorstep.
Oh, shit. And I just wasted that. Alright, let's try this again. Now, I'm not gonna go into the stats with Helios just because... I'm not going into the stats with Helios just because of the fact that he got a 50 point health increase and his armor was doubled. Those were the changes to him, and they did a 25 point increase to the base damage of the Deconstructor for its Prime version. What I'm here to talk about is the Euphona, which I actually had somebody tell me it was going to have two different firing modes. That isn't the case. It doesn't have two different firing modes, instead it has two different triggers. Now, this is with my standard left click, because I'm using keyboard and mouse. Now, this is alt fire. No changes in the firing animation, no changes in the ammo consumed. It is pretty much... They gave you two triggers for no reason. It's possible that that might be a bug, so we'll have to wait and see if there's a, hotfix. If there is, I will do an update on the Euphona. But until then, as it stands, it has a pointless second trigger that has no change. I gotta admit, it is a visually pleasing aesthetic. It reminds me a lot of the Piranha as far as its shaped, but then I've heard some other people say it looks a bit like the Magnus pistol, which I guess if when you get down to it, the Magnus can be a good gun, but I just wasn't, whenever I had it and, or the Ock Magnus, I wasn't a fan of them. Though, I can definitely see the similarities as far as the aesthetic. It is definitely very close in design to both the Piranha and the Magnus. But this is easily going to become one of my favorite secondary weapons. Continue fighting.
We're done here. The extraction team will take over from here. Time to evacuate.
Anyway, now that all that's aside, let's get into more of the visual changes with Banshee, just because of the fact that I didn't actually touch up on that prior. But now she has these weird ass little antenna things sticking off the back of her feet, which, not gonna lie, I think that those are absolutely fucking adorable. And with the subtle changes that they made to her build, she doesn't have praying mantis legs anymore. Like, that was one of the big issues that not only I, but a friend of mine had with the default skin for Banshee. And here, I'll show you here. Was, I guess they updated the mesh a while ago, but before, like, her thighs were a bit thicker than what they are now, and then her shins were about as thin as they are, and she looked like she had fucking praying mantis legs. It was creepy as shit.
Operator, were you visualizing a bloody battle?
Anyway, she's got, like, these cool-ass fins on her forearms now, in place of just the stacked armor plates. And then the change that they did with her shoulder, well, and then once again, like I said, she's got all these frilly bits hanging from her armor now. And actually what they had done was they trimmed some of this over armor plating back in place of the little frilly shit here with the cloth physics. Which is actually really nice, and the fact that it's got this little wraparound, like a sash, is just beautiful. This little shoulder bit is a little more defined and sticks out a bit more. And then, like, her base armor. Because everybody knows about the Soprano armor, which that looks 100% retarded. Apparently I can't pull up her base shoulder plate here, but here. Shit. Now, that's what her regular shoulder pad looks like, along with her default helmet. As you can see, they kind of removed the oversized fan junk from her head, and then they raised up where the armor plate mounts to her shoulder, and sent it up a little higher with this nice hollowed out energy pool. However, the kicker with the actual Banshee, with like all of the unique Banshee exclusive armor pieces that you can only use with Banshee, it's the same deal with those as it is with Volt's built-in armor, Ember Prime's built-in armor, Frost's built-in shoulder plates, even Oberon's. They are all tied to your Warframe's base colors, not your attachment colors. So, regardless, like, I could basically take her right now and color her all black, and then make her attachments be freaking neon pink, and her shoulder plate will match Banshee, not the Sandana. And not gonna lie, that tailpiece on Helios is very goofy looking. Helios Prime himself is just goofy looking, but it is nice to see another Prime Sentinel.
Tenno, a new alert has begun. It will be marked on navigation.
Anyway, unless a hotfix comes out to fix any potential bugs that may have come out with the release, this has been my on-the-spot review of Banshee Prime. And, like they said before, silence is golden. And it most certainly is. Until next time, Tenno, stick to the shadows.